It's crazy to think that Fatal Falls only came out in late January, and already in the span of just 6 weeks, a brand new update is already on the horizon. This is the 2.3 update, and the devs are calling it the Whack-A-Mole update. So, as of today, March the 5th is now in the alpha stages. I have not seen the patch notes for this version of the game yet, so I'm gonna like kind of post my reactions to these changes as I go along. So, I wanted to get this video out quicker, but for some reason, they announced it when it was like 2 a.m., and it's not really my fault. I live in the slowest time zone in the world. So, let's get into it. We're gonna start off with the new weapons. There are three in total. It looks like the emphasis on these three weapons are slow survival melee weapons. So, interesting to see what goes on with that. So the new one is called the Big Axe. I've actually tried out the public alpha with some of the footage with this weapon so far. Yeah, you'll see it in the background. I'm just gonna show like the first 15 minutes of a run on this alpha build, just so like the video doesn't get too boring. So the Big Axe, it's like a very, very slow thing, but there's a lot of breach power. If you can chain it together, it becomes extremely powerful. It's extremely slow, which I think embodies like the playstyle of survival, but it is just kind of slow, really, and it's prone to a lot of errors, so interesting to see how this is gonna work out. The second newest weapon, the Big Club. I have not played with this weapon yet, but I mean, again, it's a survival-only weapon, it looks like. And again, it's just a very big weapon with a very slow swing speed, but it does a lot of damage. And according to the devs, you can hold the attack button to charge up the downward hit, which does more damage. So kind of like the flint, almost. Interesting to see how this works out. I mean, if you really look at it, the Big Club is really just like a more flexible version of the flint. And finally, we have the Tombstone, which is a very weird weapon. I mean, just judging by the animation here, it's So it reads, leaves a tombstone to mark your enemy, and then when they die, it does something. I'm not sure exactly what it does, but... And from the looks of it, this is gonna be another survival melee weapon, so... Interesting to see if they're adding a bunch of survival melee weapons in the game, they should probably do something to balance the mutations as well as the metagame. Moving forwards on to the newest mutations, we have three in total. The first one is called Execution and this one is colorless. I've seen it in the drop-down menu in the alpha build. This mutation reads, instantly kill enemies with under 5% health, and it scales up to 15%. So the most notable weapons that come to mind are probably like tactics or brutality weapons. Since a lot of melee builds are really slow, it's not really worth it. You're probably gonna be one-shotting or two-shotting enemies in the first place. But this is a pretty interesting idea, and it also says applies to bosses. So that is a very interesting thing. Next up is Barbed Tips. This one's from Tactics, inflict X DPS to enemies per arrow stuck in them. So I can see probably like the quick bow, maybe like even if you run repeater crossbow and tactics, it can work out. It's a really interesting idea to try out. Maybe like you can even make the endless bow and quiver work, but again, only time will tell. And finally, last of the new mutations is called Point Blank. This is also from Tactics. It reads, close range attacks inflict bonus damage. So the most notable thing I can think of here is infantry bow. But again, you can probably do this with any type of like range tactics build. It's basically the polar opposite of Tranquility. And finally, moving on to the meat of the update, they're gonna revamp the entire difficulty curve, which again, well, I don't know what I'm gonna expect, so let's find out. So the text here reads, we're experimenting with a slightly new way of increasing the difficulty from one BC to the next. So it looks like they're actually making the game easier, it looks like. So normally on 3 BC, you aren't allowed like any flask charges at all. But now it looks like they're adding one minor flask after the first boss before the second. So I believe this will make the earlier versions of the game a lot easier, which I'm not sure if it's a good thing or not. On 4 BC, no more health in any transition, enemies teleport to your location, so it looks like they're scrapping malaise entirely for 4 BC. I'm not really sure what to think of this. And finally, for 5 BC, they are gonna add malaise for this. No more health in any transition areas, and enemies teleport, so it's basically the same thing as before. I mean, it doesn't really affect me all that much, so. But overall, it feels like the game is more easily approachable, and like the progression system is more linear, because what was weird before is that 5 BC was essentially the same as 4 BC but with like a bit more content at the end of the game. So it's basically like 4 BC but with DLC. But it looks like they are going to add a difficulty curve to 5 BC, so again, I'm not sure how this is going to pan out, so we'll see. And another thing is that they're adding a wait so for you to spend cells on 5BC. This is something that a lot of players requested, but it makes sense that now 5BC is getting revamped. It makes sense that you're able to spend cells in 5BC. And again, this is just a really nice change. It's just a nice quality of life change, to be honest. And finally, we're gonna move on to some balancing. Now, shockingly, they didn't really rebalance a lot of things. So here, the first line of text reads, legendary items now scale based on the sum of your two highest stats. Legendary status no longer increases the item level, and this is subject to change. So it looks like it's just a change to the legendary items. You get a lot of legendary items in your runs in the first place. It's not something that you get to control, but it would be pretty interesting to see how this new balancing changes how legendary items work. And secondly, malaise no longer increases the movement speed of enemies. Plus, mobs can no longer spawn or turn into elites in the first few seconds after an elite aggroes you. Yeah, okay, so this is kind of a big one, because before, if you had like a full, if your malaise was like fully maxed out, you will notice like a noticeable change in speed for enemies, and especially if for boss fights. This is something that you had to adjust to a lot in 2.1, because like in the conjunctivious fight, the tentacles move so fast that you have to adjust your playstyle a bit differently, because you know you have to like hold up a shield faster or roll at a earlier timing. But this is just a nice like quality of life change. And finally, bonus scrolls added to Threatred Shrines and Undying Shores. Yeah, this was like something that they just missed from the new DLC. I thought they were gonna add like a hotfix to fix this, but it looks like they're just gonna tag it onto like a much bigger update. Cause before, there was really no reason to go to the Fractured Shrines and Undying Shores, because they just gave you one less scroll stat compared to the other ones. So again, just a really nice bug fix and some quality of life changes. I'm not really gonna go too much into this, just to make the game slightly a bit better. And finally, that's it. Now, I'm assuming that they still have some bugs to fix regarding like the malaise system. Sometimes the malaise just gets cleared even though you've only hit like 50% of the biome so far. And the other bug was in my Ice Shards Pyrotechnics dual binding video, where I just like fell off the edge on the Fractured Shrines area. So again, some more bugs. It's not included here, but I'm assuming they're gonna fix a lot of them in the final build of this version of the game. So I will be doing some testing on the Alpha Branch, though I will not be showcasing the new weapons on the Alpha Branch, because they don't really like reflect the final version, since it's very likely that all of these things are still subject to change. If a weapon gets changed before the final patch, then it's not really like accurate for me to put out like builds featuring these weapons. So in the meantime, I'm just going to like post some builds that I have recorded, but in terms of the new weapons, I'm just going to leave it until the final version of 2.3 is out, and then I'll feature them. This has been a quick reaction video to the new changes in this new build, so hopefully you have enjoyed it. The biome guide is coming out in a couple of days, so stay tuned for that. So until then, thanks for watching.